Hello everyone, now I would like to take the major concept of periodic classification. Usually we will come across the periodic classification objective like from the concepts ionization potential, electron affinity, electronegativity. These are the three major concepts which will come across the objective. Now I would like to discuss the basic concept of ionization potential or ionization enthalpy. So, what is ionization enthalpy? Let us define. And we are supposed to see the trend in a group, in a period, how the factors affecting ionization enthalpy, and when the elements are given to you, how to apply the ionization potential, the trend, whether increasing order or decreasing order. So, these are the different kinds of questions which will come across ionization potential. Now, let us define what is ionization enthalpy. The minimum amount of energy required to remove an electron from the gaseous neutral isolated atom is called as ionization potential or ionization enthalpy. So, repeat the definition. The minimum amount of energy required to remove an electron from the gaseous state of gaseous neutral isolated atom is called as ionization enthalpy. For example, an element M is there in a gaseous state. To remove an electron, so whenever you are removing an electron, it becomes M plus. One electron is removed. The energy is required to remove an electron from the outermost orbit of this element to make it as unipositive ion. So the minimum amount of energy is called as what? Ionization enthalpy, usually represented as IP. As I have removed first electron from the element, this IP is called as IP1. So, what is IP1? First ionization potential. What is first ionization potential? The minimum energy required to remove the first electron from gaseous neutral isolated atom is called as ionization potential. First ionization potential. Now, see, when we are removing one electron, naturally the element is becoming into what? Unipositive ion. Now, I want to remove one more electron from an unipositive ion. So, second electron I am going to remove and dipositive ion I want to make it. So, that energy associated is called as IP2. IP2 is nothing but second ionization potential. So, what is second ionization potential? The amount, the minimum amount of energy required to remove the second electron from unipositive ion is called as second ionization potential. So, sequentially, IP3 is removing of electron from dipositive ion and making as tripositive ion. So, let us see. If we keep on going, the IP4, IP5, the values will become very high. So, what is the reason behind this? So, for example, consider initially the element, it is becoming into unipositive ion. So, after becoming unipositive ion, the electrons are reduced and the protons are remaining same. Thereby, the effective nuclear charge is more, which is focusing over the leftover electrons. So, naturally removing the second electron from unipositive ions bears more value because the effective nuclear charge is working well in unipositive ion when compared to the normal element. Now, coming to the IP3, from the dipositive ion, two electrons are already removed in a dipositive ion. I want to remove one more electron from it. But whenever the electrons are reducing, the effective nuclear charge goes on increasing. The positive charge is more, the protons attracts more the outermost electrons, and removing the electron from the dipositive ion bears still higher value when compared to IP2. So, in general, the IP3 values are high when compared to IP2, when compared to IP1. So, removing an electron from the neutral atom is easy when compared to the ions. So, this is a general trend. But of course, some conditions like some cases are there, exceptional cases where the IP2 values may be more when compared to that of IP3. That depends upon the element what we have taken. So, let us see that concept with the help of examples. Now, let us see the trend. Before going to see the factors affecting, or else let us see the factors affecting the ionization potential. Factors affecting ionization potential. So basically there are five factors affecting ionization potential. The first one is atomic size. The second one is screening or shielding effect. The third one is effective nuclear charge. The fourth one is electronic configuration. And the fifth one is electrons which are present in a particular orbital. So, orbital concept, the next one is. So, let us study the factors affecting ionization potential. Let us see the atomic size. As already you know, if the atomic size is more, definitely the nuclear influence over the outermost electron will reduce. So, it is very easy to remove the electron from the outermost orbit. The atomic size is less, the nuclear attraction over the outermost electron is very high. So, it is very highly difficult to remove the electron from the outermost orbit. So, from here what we can say, atomic size is inversely proportional to ionization potential. If atomic size is more, IP values are less. If atomic size is less, IP values will be more. The second factor is screening effect. What is screening effect? The repulsions between the inner electrons and the outermost electrons is called as screening effect. As the atomic size increases, there will be repulsions between the inner electrons and the outermost electron. So, the repulsions, thereby the screening effect will be increasing. So, if the repulsions are increasing, it is very easy to remove the electron. So, if the screening effect is more, naturally the IP values will be less. So, screening effect is also inversely proportional to what? Ionization potential. As the repulsions between the inner electrons and the outer electrons is becoming more, it's very easy to extract the electrons from the outermost orbit with minimum energy. So, screening effect is inversely proportional to what? Ionization potential. The next concept is effective nuclear charge. So, what is effective nuclear charge? The attraction between the nucleus and the outermost orbital. The electrons present in the outermost orbital. It is concerned with the attraction between the nucleus and the electrons present in the outermost orbital. As the attraction is more, it is highly difficult to remove the electron. So, thereby if effective nuclear charge is more, naturally the IP values will be very high. If effective nuclear charge is less, so naturally the IP values will be very less. So, effective nuclear charge is directly proportional to ionization potential. The next is electronic configuration. So, what is electronic configuration concept? Let us see. For example, nitrogen, the atomic number is 7. The configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. As it is known, the p orbitals are half filled. The same way, let us consider another example, neon, atomic number 10. The configuration goes 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. Here the orbitals are completely filled. So, let us come to the configuration concept. As already we know, the atoms with half filled configuration or completely filled configuration are highly stable. So, if you want to remove the electron from this, it is very highly difficult to remove or to disturb the configuration. So, for these type of elements, definitely the IP values will bear more. So, the IP values are very high when the orbitals are having half filled or completely filled configuration. Now, let us come to the concept of orbitals. So, for example, if the electrons are present in the same orbit, but we are having different orbitals, namely S, P, D, F. So, the orbitals which penetrates more towards the nucleus is highly difficult to remove the electrons. For example, SPDF, among S will be penetrated more towards nucleus when compared to P, when compared to D, when compared to F. So, thereby the IP order goes as S greater than, P greater than, D greater than, F. As the penetration of S orbital towards the nucleus is very high, it is difficult to remove the electron from S when compared to F. So, very easy to remove the electron from F, next D, next P and next S. So, this is orbitals concept. So, these are the various factors affecting ionization potential. Now, let us see the ionization potential, the trend along the period and along the group. So, let us consider the group. In a group, as the atomic number increases, the atomic size increases. The incoming electron goes into the next orbit. So thereby, the screening effect is increasing. The repulsions between the inner electrons and outer electrons works well. So naturally, what happens to IP values? Already we have seen, if screening effect is more, the IP values will be less. So in a group, if we come down from top to bottom, the IP values decreases. As screening effect or shielding effect is working well or working more, as the electron is entering into the new orbit, the IP values decreases. And coming to the period, so in a period from left to right, if you are moving from left to right, as the atomic number increases, the electron enters into the same orbit. As already we came to know, the effective nuclear charge works well, it operates more, thereby the atomic size reduces because of effective nuclear charge, and the IP values will increase. So in a period from left to right, if you move, the IP values increases. So this is the trend of ionization potential. In a group from top to bottom, the IP values decreases, and in a period, the IP values increases. But same, there like in a period, we are having some exceptional cases too. But in general, this is the trend which will be following through group and a period. Now let us apply, let us see in a period what is happening to the IP values. Now let us see like in a period, as already I have discussed, in a period as we are moving from left to right, the IP values increases. So but let us see the exceptional case. Let me consider the second period. The elements present in the second period are lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon. These are the elements present in the second period. Now let us see the trend, how it is going to occur. Let us write the configuration. For example, the lithium or the configuration 2s1. For beryllium configuration, outermost configuration is 2s2. For boron, 2s2, 2p1. Carbon, 2s2, 2p2. Nitrogen, 2s2, 2p3. Oxygen, 2s2, 2p4. Fluorine, 2s2, 2p5. And the neon configuration is 2s2, 2p6. So in general, what we have discussed is, in a period, effective nuclear charge works well, and if you are moving from left to right, the IP values increases. Let us see in which the trend it is going on, the like the increasing order or the decreasing order, let us see. If you see the lithium, the outermost electron is 2s1. If you remove one electron, it is going to the nearest inert gas configuration, helium. So easily it can lose. So naturally, IP value of lithium is less. Coming to the beryllium, it got completely filled configuration of s orbital. Compare boron, 2s2, 2p1. Here, if boron loses one electron, it is going to completely fill configuration. So while comparing to beryllium and boron, which will be having less IP value? Boron. Though in a period, the IP value increases, as it is having stable configuration, completely filled configuration. And secondly, this boron, if it is ready to lose electron, it is getting completely filled configuration. Boron will be having less when compared to beryllium. And the next, carbon. Naturally, in the period, the IP values increases. Come to nitrogen and oxygen comparison. Nitrogen is having half filled configuration, but oxygen is having incompletely filled configuration. If oxygen is readily losing one electron, it reaches to half filled configuration. So the IP values for oxygen bears less when compared to nitrogen. The next is fluorine. Anyway, it needs one electron. Instead of losing, always it try to gain the electron. And come to neon, naturally it is a completely filled configuration. The IP values are very high for inert gas elements. So this is the increasing order, like lithium bears less when compared to boron, when compared to beryllium, carbon, nitrogen, fluorine, neon. So this is the trend how it follows in a period, in the second period. The same you can apply for the third period and fourth period. In the third period we are having which element? Phosphorus. Sulfur. Sulfur bears less value when compared to that of phosphorus. In the same way here, beryllium and boron, aluminium bears less when compared to that of magnesium. So though in general we'll discuss the IP values whenever we are going in a period, so it the IP values increases,
But there are some exceptional cases, the configuration consideration is also very important. The elements, whenever easily they are losing the electrons, reaching to the nearest inert gas configuration or half-fill configuration, bears very less values when compared to the elements like nitrogen, which is having half-fill configuration to disturb their inertness. So this is the way how you are supposed to apply the objective for the given one. So usually they will be giving four elements and they may be asking you to arrange the increasing order or decreasing order of their IP values. So that's the concept of ionization potential.